My name is Stephen Kim, and I'm a third-year nephrology fellow at UCSF. And right now I'm working on the bioartificial kidney project. So the goal of our project is to create an implantable device that provides renal replacement therapy for patients with end-stage renal disease. So I grew up in Colorado. Mm-hmm. Both my parents are scientists. My dad's actually an engineer as well. And so I grew up in Colorado and made my way out to California for undergraduate. So I did my undergraduate studies at UC Berkeley in bioengineering, and then decided I wanted to go to med school. And so I went to Philadelphia at Drexel Med, and then went to residency in Boston, and then found my way back home to San Francisco. So now I'm here finishing up my nephrology fellowship. So nephrology is the study of the kidney. So basically patients whose kidneys are failing or are damaged, they come to see us, and we help diagnose what problems they have with their kidneys and treat them accordingly. Nephrology is very analytical, and out of kind of all the specialties, I felt like used the most, had the most engineering aspect to it, and so it kind of felt like a natural fit. The overall lab here uses what's called silicon technology, or MEMS technology. Basically, it uses technology that's found in like your iPhone and your computer, and adapts that for biological purposes. And so the overall goal of our lab is to build a implantable bioartificial kidney using this technology. But my particular interest is looking at how those materials interact with our blood when we implant them into the body. And even more specifically, patients whose kidneys have failed, their blood is a lot different than a normal person's blood. So I also want to look at how these materials, when we implant them into a patient with end-stage renal disease, how it will react and how the patient will react to that device. I think in science, and especially today, everything is very multidisciplinary. So it's very rare for one scientist or one person to, you know, revolutionize treatment of patients, or, you know, revolutionize healthcare. I think everything is done in collaboration and borrowing ideas and collaborating with people. So I think one of the big things and great things about this lab is that, you know, we have people with engineering backgrounds, with MD backgrounds, with biology backgrounds, and we all kind of work together for this one goal. So I would say that the biggest thing is being able to collaborate, and I don't think, you know, one person in isolation can accomplish much, but, you know, together in a big collaborative group, we can do a lot. What I've seen is that it's not always, you know, the smartest person or the one that gets the best grades that necessarily turns out to be the best or the most successful. I think as long as you kind of find what you're passionate about and are dedicated and work hard, that good things will happen, and it's expected that you'll have obstacles to overcome. And I would find it hard to believe that, you know, the people who are the most successful had their whole path laid out for them early on and knew exactly what they wanted to do at each turn. And I think kind of the adventure is achieving those obstacles and overcoming them.